Probably eating Rice Krispies in his car or something.
Everything litty, I love when it's hot. Turn to the city, I broke all the notch.
What's going on, guys? We're jumping in. We're doing a shoulder workout today. So I am Rowan. We got Cal over here. Hey. He's going to be mic'd up with us today, too. And of course, we got you boys as well. So we got Sebastian and Oliver. Jordan's running late. He's probably eating Rice Krispies in his car or something, but he's going to be a couple minutes late today.
7 meals later.
Nothing too crazy. In general, how I structure most of my days right now, I'm doing kind of like a Jordan Peters density day split. So it's pretty much push-pull legs and then a shoulder push. And then a back and hamstrings day. So this is gonna be the shoulder push day. We're gonna be doing two pressing movements. We're gonna open up with a pressing movement today. I have a bit of a pinched nerve in my neck. I don't know what's going on. It's pretty bad, but I did a lot of mobility. I'm trying to get things released. I'm gonna try to take it through the workout today. I might not be able to go full intensity. So majority for most of us is still progressive overload, just trying to increase the weights that we have. A lot of these are gonna be centered around two top sets. So we're gonna be doing two main presses. We're gonna be doing probably two different lateral raises, a little bit of rear delts, which I'm gonna have to be careful on because of my shoulder and my neck. But we're gonna get done what we can, and we're gonna get some triceps done at the end of today. It's gonna be good. Let's get it. All right, cool. So we're gonna start with the Smith press today. We kind of just rotate our pressing patterns, our shoulder pressing patterns, based off of what we're progressing and what's not. But I like to do a Smith press for the fact that it's a step path movement, so we can push pretty close to failure. We have it bench set at about 75 degrees here, maybe a little bit up from that. I like to go back from 90 degrees just so that we're within that scapular plane. A little bit safer on the shoulders, and in general, we can push a little bit harder. So we're going to go ahead and probably do two warm-up sets, two working sets. Chuck a plate on.
I feel great.
It's good?
Actually, yeah, it's not too bad. So next to that, okay, so we're going to push weight up to our normal working sets here today. A couple things you want to think about, like with a Smith press like this, it's very much a lengthened range focus. So we're really kind of focusing on the stretch. Obviously, we can't converge the hand all the way to the top and actually come across the body at all, but that's fine. We're really just trying to keep good constant tension. With the Smith machine, we're not going to be very explosive with it anyway, so we're trying to keep steady tension pretty much throughout the whole movement. With that as well, we want to keep the elbows underneath the bar. We have a little bit of bend to that lower back, just trying to keep ourselves, our hips within the pad, making sure we don't slide out. And I find with this as well, we don't want to be taking too much rest on either the top or the bottom end. We're trying to just keep smooth tension through the whole way and try to take it to a point of failure. And the good thing about the Smith machine is we can do that pretty safely. So we're going to get after it.
Easy. Easy. Yep. Second. Good. Beat me. One. Beat me. Come on. Five. Finish.
That's all I got there.
Same spot, dude. The exact same part of the rep, too.
Yeah.
If we're a little bit off with the Smith angle, it's going to be hard to track and align our joints naturally, right? So those little, like, inch differences with where the bench is relative to the bar make a big fucking difference.
Good. Couple more.
Let's go, Jordan.
Let's go. Yep. Good. Nice. One more. I'm here. Let's go.
Fight.
Come on. Get up. Drive through that. Come on. There you go. Leave it.
And that's kind of ideally where we want it. We don't want like 3-4 reps on the first working set, right? Just want one.
Another big tip of today is make sure you dress for the workout. Oversized shirts are best for leg day. And compression pants. Or short shorts.
Yeah.
And then stringers, of course, for push day.
For shoulder day.
You're an idiot if you don't have a stringer somewhere or a cutoff somewhere for shoulder day, you're doing it wrong.
For sure.
But you can't take it off right away, though. You gotta warm
up. No.
First pressing movement, first lateral raise, it's gotta
be off. Yeah, I usually do a set of lateral and then I take off.
First set of laterals, we're good.
We're one. That's literally what I do.
Shoulders probably look big now.
Yeah. Fuck.
All right. Yep.
Easy.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
Get angry, let's go. Come on, get up.
You got it.
Right.
There you go.
Fuck. Good.
All right, so next up, we're going to move into a lateral raise. So a couple different variations you can do here. We just have a free weight lateral raise on the program. So you can change this a little bit if you want, but we're going to be doing a chest-supported lateral raise. So benefits of this, obviously, we take away from the momentum that you can use trusting your body into the movement by just jamming your chest against the pad. So we're going to kind of squeeze our butt a little bit here, keep our chest forward. And once again, we're still within that scapular plane. So elbows are not directly out to the side, shrugging up. We're slightly in front. We're slightly internally rotated, almost like we're pouring out the dumbbell. Top end is always the hardest part. We don't want to rush out of that. So we're going to take our time near there. We're going to push to the point of getting partials here. So the thing is, with the strength curve here, we're going to be failing at the top. Just because we can't get it to the top doesn't mean we should stop. We should take it to the point of probably 50% range of motion on this. But I'm able to get them up all the way. We get to the point where I'm starting doing here a little bit. When they start looking like we're barely getting any reps, then we're going to let them go. But there's still a lot more we can get out of that point from getting a full rep to getting a half rep, right? So we're going to take advantage of that today.
I like it.
That's it. Oh, yeah, those are tough. That's like the one movement where I'm trying to really be conscious not to strain my neck. Like a lateral raise, like, at the very top, you're used to like thrusting your head forward like that. Nice. Good. Attaboy. What, we only did one top set of presses, basically. Well, two top sets, I guess, technically, but one was a bit more of like the strength set. But then we're going to move on to our next press that we'll be doing later on in the workout. We're going to head over to a plate-loaded press where we can kind of push a little bit harder, but that's going to be a little bit higher up. But in general, we're going to do a bit more volume with the metabolic style stuff, like the side raises, any kind of front raise you may have in. I'm not a huge fan of front raises. I'd rather train presses more. So we have, two presses, more side raises with higher volume, and a little bit of rear delts involved in there too. And of course, we have some triceps at the end, which is going to be a bit more higher volume too. So just more reps within the set, kind of pushing to that point of metabolic stress rather than like the whole mechanical tension, 5 to 8 rep style stuff. I think it's important to have that in. But it's important to try to cover all ends, all mechanisms of hypertrophy, if you will, at the same time. Making sure we're still chasing that strength in that top end set, but still getting the volume in and the metabolic stress in, especially for side raises. I mean, everybody that has big delts. Jordan, your delts got huge, and it's from doing a lot of volume, a lot of density, you know what I mean? So getting a lot of reps in a short amount of time.
I'm actually going to drop the weight because I feel like that wasn't enough reps.
Yeah, sure. Even like anywhere, trying to finish anywhere 15 to 20.
I only got 8 or 9 before I did the partials. Yeah. So.
What we can do it before too. It's just whatever works. Yeah. So it has to be either like Friday night or the weekends.
Attaboy.
But definitely there's some stuff you can do. And like I said, like our prices just went up too. So it's.
Good. Okay, so next we're moving into another press. Yeah. So more of a set path kind of press. Similar kind of style to the Smith. With this, we have the hammer strength one. The big thing with this is just going to be elbows a bit more in front rather than externally rotated. With this as well, this is a big tip that I used. I took this from Joe Bennett, hypertrophy coach, one of the best guys in the industry. When you're setting up for this, a lot of people are wondering, where do I set the seat up? You want to make sure it's within your natural range of motion within your shoulder. So if I have the seat up here, I'm of course trying to stack my elbow underneath my hand. If I have my elbow back here and I'm unable to do a lat pull down to get underneath with both my hands on this, then it's going to be outside my range of motion. So I'm going to set this up. I can't even get my hands underneath there. This isn't a safe spot for me to press from, right? So I'm going to drop this bench down a bit, give myself a bit more space. Let's try there. So down a few inches.
And you got to bury the seat too, right? Yeah.
Hands are underneath. Remember the pressing angle is up and out. It's not up this way. So I don't want to have my elbows back here. I want to have my elbows stacked underneath the bar. Underneath and behind, lat pull down, I got about an inch of ROM there, right? So that's within my range of motion. This is safe for me to press from. So I'm gonna sit back, elbows slightly in front and underneath the handles, pressing up and straight up over the top. Very basic. I like to use a little bit of head movement with this just to help position the rest of the body. So we kind of lean our head forward in just a little bit and then we drive it back as we come back. All I'm trying to do is just align the rest of my body to fit the mechanics of the machine. That's it.
It all just like
no need to overcomplicate it.
Why are you so sweaty, Jordan? Jesus. What's this?
I'm gonna put my head right into that.
Is that the secret to large arms?
I'm gonna dig.
That's why you're bigger than us.
I don't believe that to be true. I'm 225.
Yeah.
Taller.
I'm taller.
You're tall. Yeah, exactly.
I was like 236, but
if I'm going off weight, I win.
It's all in my calves, though, so it's not fair. All right, let's go.
Easy money.
Nice.
Easy.
Yep. Keep going. Smooth. You're in a rhythm. Yeah.
Jesus.
Come on. Keep going. Yep. Yep.
One.
Yep. Get up. Come on. All you on the way down.
See the bench move on me?
Yeah.
Like rep six? Just fucking.
Are you seeing me? I kicked it though.
Did you?
I kicked it hard, like to make sure it was in.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Real friends. Yep. Easy. Good. I'm here. Come on. Yep. Good.
That's that tricep.
One. One. I'm here. Come on. Set. Good set. Good set. I'm going to say like a back off.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think we got to adapt and improvise and overcome. Shout out to Bear Grylls today. So we're going to back off a little bit.
Me?
Honestly, the goal rep range here is 10 to 15. I think I got 11 on the last. I can almost guarantee if I try to do this again, I probably won't get 10. So I hate to preactively reduce the weight, but just given where we are in the workout, we're a meal or two in. You kind of got to understand where your strength is going to be best. So here I'm actually going to back the weight down a little bit. Also makes sense for Jordan and Cal for them to get more in a 10 to 15 range rather than trying to get what, maybe 5 reps on the next set. I'm not gonna get much out of that, especially at this point in the workout. So try to keep the strength focused movements and the lower rep focused movements at the beginning of the workout when you're gonna have that energy. And then once again more of the metabolic stress style stuff near the end. So we're gonna reduce the weight a bit.
So you're not allowing that muscle to have the ability to contract.
Alright, let's go.
Right? And you're resting because it's huge. Right? Which is fine when you're not doing anything, but when you're working, it can't be there when you're working out.
That's it.
It has to be in a different position. Which is all I out of this.
That's right. Good. Keep coming. Good. I'm here. Okay. Let's go. Good.
One more.
Yep.
Me on the way down.
Yep.
Nice.
Dude, I'm here. Let's go.
Give that the advantage. Right, so I would just line it up.
Good,
so
one. Come on.
Opposed to if it's here, you can
drive.
Right, so shoulder up and back.
Down slow. Set control it. The way down.
So like,
attaboy, good shit.
Force more shoulder rotation.
Track your calories. Yes. That's the biggest one. Track your calories.
Yeah.
Make sure you're eating more than you're burning. I guess probably the easiest. That is the most scientifically evidence-based method. Yeah, just eat a lot. You probably have to be uncomfortable. Eat to the point of being uncomfortable. But not to the point of losing insulin sensitivity.
I used to go for walks in between my meals.
That's a Stan Efforting thing.
Like, I literally, I wouldn't finish my meal, and I'd walk outside around my parking lot, and then go back in and finish it.
I'd walk while I'm eating.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, okay, top end numbers. And these are good people to take the advice from, because you guys are bigger guys, right? My top end numbers for off season, I know the whole main gaining thing is popular right now. Not a fan when you're trying to actually put on mass and get yourself in like a positive state to grow, a good environment to grow.
Right? As long as you don't cause health issues.
Yeah, exactly. And you're able to maintain a good body fat percentage. I would just try to get away with eating as much as we can while staying lean, right? That seems like the logical solution to me.
I eat 5,400 calories a day.
That's my next question. I was going to ask you, you're 5,400. Yeah. Coach Jordan, he's been up to around 5,500, 6,000 before, right? Yeah, so, and I've been up around, I've been to 5,000 before around 4,500. So that's not your basic, your average American diet recommendation for a male. Trying to get away with eating as much as we possibly can while still maintaining a good body fat percentage and keeping ourselves in striking range.
And I'm still struggling to gain weight. Like, I have a hard time holding it where I am.
I think we can all agree that this is harder than the diet.
It is.
I can't wait to not have to eat. I can't wait to be hungry.
Yeah, and we're all in different phases right now, which is funny, because I did a show, 8 weeks ago? So I'm still kind of coming out of that post-show ghrelin spike period. So mine's starting to settle down now, whereas these guys are just fucking sick of eating. But like, you asked me 3 weeks ago, I could eat all fucking day. But it's funny how ghrelin kind of, it's our hunger hormone. It'll kind of stave off a little bit, almost the further away from a dieting period we are. So these guys are at the point they don't want to eat at all. I could still eat quite a bit. I'm still hungry. But that's going to change very soon here. Give me a month or two, and I'm going to absolutely hate food. I'm going to hate it.
Let's go.
Um, let's do a quick talking about this one. So with this face full, we're obviously moving into rear delts. We get a little bit of traps and general upper back involved in this too. I like to do face fulls with a good degree of external rotation. And the benefit with this, we're moving like us, we're doing back double biceps all the time, right? So it actually helps to train that position and actually getting that rear delt activated and that shoulder kind of rotated externally. So with that, I just like a little pause when you come back here. Trying to keep the hands above the shoulders, elbows about shoulder height. We're not trying to have excessive elevation in the scapula or anything like that. So we're trying to keep our shoulder blade relatively sturdy. We're aligned near the end, but we're not hanging out here. We're coming back, we're spending more of our time in that back and externally rotated range, slight pause there, coming forward and then right back. But we're not hanging out too much in that lengthened range. So more of a shortened range movement. And once again, externally rotating, pulling that rope apart, trying to get the rear delts involved as much as we can. Cal's gonna demonstrate and kill it here.
I will do perfect for him. As long as
he's got big traps in your delts, so perfect for this. Yeah, that's good. And that is a back double bicep pose, right? Want to get good at doing this shit? Then train in the same positions that you're gonna be posing in.
For that reason.
I just need bigger biceps. I'm buoyant and I feel like all the way down the left side.
Yeah, being
my check-ins yesterday, but he lost his phone at EDC, so I don't think he had the same number. Never emailed me, nothing.
Single arm tricep extension, big benefit here. We're just trying to line the elbow up with the line of force from the cable. I like using the cuff because it kind of takes away from the grip strength. We will have the tricep feel first, and that's the goal with an isolation movement like this. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to lock my upper arm in. I'm going to adjust my body to the cable. So I'm not trying to come from the side here. Locking my elbow up, making sure it's directly in line with the line of force from that cable. I can, however I want to, brace off this. I don't even need to hold this, but I'm going to. And I'm just going to fully extend that elbow, fully shorten position as much as I can. Very basic, very straightforward, but it's a good way to finish off the triceps. Thing is, the triceps already got a lot of work from the pressing that we did today, so they only need probably about two movements, if that, at the end.
Yeah.
We're just going to take it all the way we can. Alright, so that's pretty much it for the informative style stuff that we're doing today. We're just going to finish up the rest of the workout a little bit faster pace. We only have a few movements left anyways. Thank you guys for tuning in today. I appreciate you guys coming and checking out. Stay in touch with Jordan, the boys, Cal's in contest prep here. We're going to have another big workout video coming pretty soon. So we're probably going to be training back and hands, legs, something that's a little bit more hardcore. But either way, appreciate you guys coming and checking in. Make sure to follow on Instagram. Of course, give myself a follow on YouTube. You guys already probably follow Johnny. He's over there doing a few battles, but thank you guys for tuning in. Take care. Train hard. Peace. So you have real friends. So you have real friends. I got my train pole. I got these chains rolled up. No need to change codes. I'll be finding what I gotta keep me no holes. If fucking the same old ones, I try to move on and end up right back inside this position. Time four when I top back in a five. So alive, I could die right now. Come back, still alive. You was fake with the head shake. Now you come back, still a fives. On the one umbrella mile. Left about a grandmama crib. Then I went back to the ways. Went back to the field. Had to hit a step back for the plays. Step back with a 10 pack. Make 10 rack for the day. Impact on play. Been strapped since pit strap. Now I sit back on a rave. Damn, look how shit changed. Couldn't see it back then. Now you say you seeing what I've been saying. Sick from the Himalayas. Na 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 na. When I woke up in the building, all you hear is eh, 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 eh. Didn't love me at the bottom, but they wanna love a nigga at the top, though. Innocent since Pac, now I got the ball head with the Pac flow. Neck looking like Pablo with the key stuffed in the Tahoe. Been lit since I blow out in Oslo with my eyes low. Said I got a million ties. You got a million ways to get it. Well, I got a million five. I really would donate a mil to my city. It's getting too real to survive. Only the trill to survive. You don't wanna get caught up in a situation where all